right, folks. Well, it's the hot part of the day here in Florida, but it is running about 10 degrees cooler now. And I'm going to be real light on Sunny. She's already done that little bit of lunging. So this is just going to be to give you a few exercises that you can bring to the saddle after you've done your groundwork. You've been already been working on lateral flexion on the sides, and you've already been working on respect and control. And again, you can watch my beginning lunging video on YouTube under Lisa Kimbrell Hutchinson or Joy Reaper and find out how to start a horse on beginning lunging. Eventually, doing all of the groundwork necessary and teaching the horse to yield to you and becoming the horse's leader, etc., etc., will give you a horse that will stand still and quiet, will be calm and relaxed. And I'm not going to say that Sunny never tries to sneak away from me. I probably am third on her priority list. Food comes first, friends come second, and that's debatable, and I come third. Now, sometimes she'll begin to walk off toward a friend, and if I say, "Sunny, whoa," she'll stop dead in her tracks and turn to me because of obedience and because of respect, not because it's her choice. Her choice is to be with her friend, but I'm telling her it's time to do something right now. And when it comes to that, when it comes to friend or leader, in the same way that a parent would have a child, you know, understand that if we have a schedule and we have a doctor's appointment or a soccer practice or baseball practice or gymnastics practice or a horseback riding lesson, that time is a scheduled time and it's time to work. You can go play with your friends later. But you'll get a horse that will, you can quiet to the point that the horse will stand still and follow you, obey you, respect you, allow you to stand around and have conversations with your friends. And then you can begin teaching trick training. She only knows one trick, and that trick is to beg for food. I've never tried to do any tricks with her, but I've thought that maybe in her old age it would be a good idea. So I'm going to attempt something right now, and I'm going to see if she'll stand here. Now, this can be applicable, my practice in this, to when we do EXCA, because we might, if when I start EXCA, I might be asked to get off my horse, walk over to some hay bales, hide behind the hay bales, and then come back to my horse. And I want my horse to still be standing there when I come back. So I'm trying to not give her the body language to move her hindquarters or anything like that, but to just give her the body language that says, right now, I'm doing something around you. Yeah, I'm not holding your lead rope, but you still are paying attention to me, even if you are going to sleep because you're old. But her, you know, she's still got her attention on me. Her ears are cocked. She's not trying to run off to the Arabian that's down in the other corner of the arena. She's not trying to go over there and eat grass or over there and eat grass. She's just standing quietly where I put her. And if that means that she has to sleep, she'll sleep. But if I want her to wake up, she'll wake up. So I'm going to go ahead and try this. And I might get a little dirty. Okay, she's beginning to pay attention. Horses anticipate what we're going to do. And she's beginning to think that I just might want her hindquarters moved. And when I bend, it's going to make it even more confusing for her. Because usually I'll bend my body that way at the same time that I look at her hindquarters. So she could easily confuse bending with hindquarters movement. So I'm going to have to be a little careful here. Careful. Stand. Okay, so now I'm on her side. And she still hasn't moved, but she's in anticipation mode, I can tell. She's not even beginning to anticipate what I'm going to do because I've never done it before. So as long as she doesn't get the body language that says move, I need her to stand still. And so far, I haven't given her any kind of body language command to move. Usually when I go to get up in the saddle, you know, I'll put my weight in it so there's a foot in it, and that's her cue to, you know, that we're getting ready to ride. She still stands there, but I've never done this. Okay, and I got myself dirty, but that was a first.
Now,
I trusted Sunny, and hopefully she trusted me. She didn't get freaky or flighty or wonder what was going on. She knows it's me, and she knows that I give body language, and she hasn't received any body language yet, so to her, that was just something brand new. So,
good girl.
I mean, that's a big good girl. Another reason that you want these important good manners is you don't want your horse to run off between haltering and bridling. Now, I usually will tie my halter just like this around a horse's neck to make sure they don't run off. But there's still the chance. So, I'm in an O-ring snaffle. Slip it in, get one ear over the headstall, another ear over the headstall, and right now I'm going to go into checking my tack mode.